today's session will be on opening ourselves up and attracting a soulmate in 2022, or whenever you're watching this. Today's video will not have any tapping, but it will have some rattle sounds like these. And also some scissor sounds. So if you know that these sounds will inhibit you from falling asleep, then just click the playlist up above with videos that have no tapping at all. Before we get into the video, I want to take some time to thank our sponsor, Bobble, first. Bobble is a language learning app that offers you over a dozen different languages to choose from. Estoy aprendiendo español, since I currently live in Ibiza and will be traveling to Latin America soon. Learning a language is the perfect goal for 2022, whether you are traveling like me or want to add a new skill to your resume. I personally love Bobble as it teaches you real-life conversations through short 10-minute interactive lessons.
Un vaso de agua, por favor.
Un vaso de agua, por favor.
It also teaches you much more than just vocab words. They teach you about the language's culture, the people, the history, and much more.
This is actually weird because in Spanish we have different words for bridge depending on the region.
Bobble has been so kind to give all of you 65% off your subscription along with a 20-day money-back guarantee. That way you can try out the app risk-free. To activate the discount, click on the link in the description box. Thanks again, Bobble, for sponsoring today's video. Now let's get back to the Reiki session. All right, so let's get started with our session. We're going to start first with some guided relaxation in combination these selenite wands, which I'll be gliding over your aura. All I want you to do right now is to get really, really cozy, really comfortable, making any small adjustments with your body. And then gently drawing your awareness to your breath. Slowly building the inhales and the exhales, making them a little bit deeper, a little bit longer. And while you continue to breathe deeply, I will be using these selenite wands to remove any energies of the day that you're ready to let go of. Removing any conversations that you've had that are lingering in your mind. Removing any anxieties, any stresses. So continuing to breathe deeply. Just feel the energies of the day falling away, being gently brushed out of your aura with the selenite wand. Focus closer in on your mind as well. sure that your mind is a bit more clear. So I'm going to come up behind you here. Just gently brush from the top of your head down. And just remove any staticky energy, any static, repetitive, intrusive thoughts. Any worries that you might be having. Staying connected to your breath. Using the rattle to ground any remaining energy, any sense of overwhelm, or maybe if you've been very social today, and you can feel the energies of other people still circulating through your system. Just allow the sound of the rattle to ground these energies. So I'm going to come up behind you, go over the top of your head, since we'll be working mainly with the heart chakra today, which is located right here in the middle of your chest. I have selected this rose quartz crystal, which we'll be using to prep our space, our heart space, energetically for the cord cutting and the plucking that we'll be doing. So we'll be using this to soften the energy so that it's a lot easier to cut cords with people from our past so that we can move on to better relationships that are more in alignment with our soul. So I'm just going to be gently placing this above your heart chakra. And I'll be sending a combination of the rose quartz frequencies along with Reiki energy. So just imagine this beautiful piece of rose quartz hovering in front of your heart, in the center of your chest. Feel its loving energy connecting to your heart, softening the energies. See if you can soften the bones of your ribcage, the muscles in between them, and your shoulder blades on the back, allowing the walls to come down, to soften. These were just a few Reiki symbols to help activate the healing, but also to improve balance within this chakra. There's anyone that you're ready to let go of? Any cords that you still feel attached between you and a person from your past, an ex-lover, ex-boyfriend, partner, girlfriend, whatever they were to you? Just bring that person to mind, and we are very gently going to be cutting cords with this person or multiple people. This is a very gentle process. To be able to move forward in life and attract in new people that fit us better, that are healthier for us. It's very important that we let go of the past, and we heal and we learn from it. So once and for all, let's let go of these people. We're doing this in a loving, kind way. As we cut these cords, you can send some love to these people. Thank them for the lessons that they taught you and the time you have spent with them, the good memories and the bad memories. Just send them on their way with love. Sometimes we might have doubts about letting go of a certain person, especially if we believe that they are our soulmates, but maybe for some reason it didn't work out. It's really important that we let go of these people as well. They truly are soulmates. Somehow life will bring you back together. For now, just let go. Allow yourself to move on, to move forward. Let's do a few more here. And as these cords are cut, just feel the lightness coming back into your heart. Notice your heart softening, becoming lighter. Just going to brush through it energetically with this small feather. And I will be plucking any remaining parts of the cord from your heart. Making sure the cord is fully detached, unplugged. Just allow any feelings to arise. Sometimes we have to go through a period of grief, and that's completely fine. There's nothing wrong with that. I highly encourage you to go through that process and just honor the feelings that you feel. You can miss someone, but still not want them back. Okay, just a few more. Making sure our heart is cleaned out again energetically so that we have space in our heart for new relationships, for potential soulmate connection this year. And we want to make sure that our heart is open and receptive. Last one. Seal in those openings that we've just created from the cords that we have pulled. I will be using this phosphosiderite heart to help heal those cords we have just let go of, those attachments with those people. Just take a moment to connect in with the crystal here, the phosphosiderite. And just imagine it creating a seal over those little openings. Allow it to connect in with your heart. So now that we have prepped you energetically by drawing out anything that was no longer beneficial for us, anything that we are ready to let go of now, it is time to call in this love. And I think it's really important to first find that love within us. From the moment we have it internally, it's easier for the external world to reflect it back to us. So sometimes it can be hard to connect to our own love within our heart. So what I'm going to do is actually have you connect in with the loving energy of the earth first and allow that to draw up the body towards your heart and fill your heart there. So let's bring your attention to your feet first. Gently going to place my hands on your feet, creating a grounding. relaxation. So just imagine my hands gently resting on your feet, helping them to ground. You can feel the Reiki energy entering through the tops of your feet here. And then through the soles of your feet, I want you to imagine roots shooting down from your feet, energetic roots. Allow these roots to grow further and further down into the earth, going really, really deep. Until they reach all the way to the center of the earth, the middle of the earth. And then from there, just imagine drawing up the energy of the earth. This loving, pure energy. Drawing it up your root system through the soles of your feet and then up into the body. Traveling through the legs first, into the hips, belly and back, all the way up to your heart, where the energy connects in with your heart, plugs in there. And just imagine like a tank or like a battery filling up your heart with the energy of the earth. Allowing your heart to grow bigger and bigger. And as your heart fills up, you can feel it radiating out to every other part of your body, into your arms, your neck, your head. And for a moment, see how much of this love you can hold into your body. Draw it up from the earth, filling every cell of your body, until you feel like you're about to burst with love. You can't contain it within your skin anymore. And then just allow this love to radiate out in the form of energy, in the form of light, from your own body to everything around you. Good. Stay connected to these energies and keep drawing in the energies of the earth. While you stay connected to these energies, I'll be using this fluorite agate point to write some positive affirmations into your aura to really set in this love on a deeper level, deep into your subconscious. So stay connected to the energy of the earth, keep drawing it up to your heart, allowing it to expand out to the rest of your body and everything around you. How much love can you hold? How much love can you absorb from the earth? Gently pressing that into your mind. I am worthy of love. I am worthy of love. I am lovable just as I am. I am lovable just as I am. I am lovable just as I am. Lovable just as I am. Love comes easy to me. 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 Shh. Shh. breath for love. The very last thing we're going to do is work on your crown chakra, which is located right here at the top of your head there, and we're going to do that to invite in more divine guidance, more synchronicities and signs when it comes to our future soulmate. So for that, the last crystal we'll be using today is this scolocite crystal. It looks a little bit like a butterfly wing or an angel wing, if you can see that. It has all of these little striations or lines, which makes it look like a wing or a flower petal. Scolocite is great to invite in peacefulness and connection, which is perfect because we want to invite in peacefulness when it comes to relationships. We want to invite in relationships and connections that feel very healthy, that put our nervous system at ease instead of triggering it. And of course, we want to call in connection as well, connection to our spirit guides, or if you are religious, to your God, to help you with giving divine signs or synchronicities when it comes to attracting in your soulmate. So I'll be placing this one just at the top of your head, and I'll be sending Reiki energy through my palms at the same time, just to help activate, open up, and balance out your crown chakra. So you might be able to feel a slight tingling sensation at the top of your head or your crown. Just imagine you have a satellite dish at the top of your head. That's kind of what I imagine the crown chakra to be like energetically or symbolically. It's a place through which we receive energy information from other realms. So just strengthening the connection with our crown. So that we might be divinely guided. Now just feel the energies of your crown connecting with your heart, creating a solid foundation, a solid connection here. Really good. I'm going to put the scolocite to the side for now. And then draw the activating symbol on your crown as well. Chakra, chakra, chakra. Gently press that in. Today's session. I hope that you enjoyed, and I wish you a lot of luck on your journey towards your soulmate. I hope that you enjoyed.